Hello, this is RedMcNed, and welcome back to the saga. In this one, we're going to be doing part two. I'm going to call it part two of doing this tower. The last episode, I showed how to make it with a stationary face, but I also showed that I have something set up in the works to make it be automated and to sort of move. So this is the first time I've actually done a tutorial that involves redstone. So it's going to be kind of interesting to see how this goes down. Hopefully, I'll just be methodical and not rush things too much and try to be as clear and concise as possible. So what I'm going to start with is the wool. And I'm going to tell you the amounts of wool that I actually use. This thing will ultimately require 16 green wool, 44 red, 17 blue, 35 light blue, 38 cayenne, 40 yellow, and 42 white. You'll notice something about the amounts that I'm carrying is they're all over that amount, or those amounts. And I like to bring a little extra just in case I drop some. I have to go all the way down. Or if I made a mistake counting, I usually add about 5 to any number I think it is. Another thing that's going to be needed is 32 pistons. This thing uses a lot of pistons. So I'm going to make those. 1, 2, 3, go! Yeah! Yeah, got plenty of that. So I'm going to carve my way into this. I'm standing right below the clock face. I'm going to be coming in here, and I'm actually going to be making a floor at the level of the stairs, just so I can have room to build and stuff. All right, next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put down a few torches just in case it, or just, I don't know, yeah, a couple torches just in case it gets dark. Just in case it gets dark. And this is going to seem kind of counterproductive, but I'm actually going to get rid of a lot of walls right now. So I'll show you just how many I get rid of in a second. Okay, so what I've done is I've taken out most quite a lot, actually. I'm going to get rid of this. Just because I want it to be even. I took out basically all the walls going down this up to just above this block right there, where it starts to taper more. Just so I can get a nice clear view of what I'm working with. I didn't take out the side wheels or the face. And I have this kind of scaffolding to kind of keep give me spots to stand if I need it. So what I'm going to do, just so I can see, is I'm going to remove the face of this clock. You know, clock tower, I gotta say, that's a good look for you. You really So for putting down the wall, I'm gonna start in the front. And the first piece is actually going to go not here, but right behind it. I kind of meant to do that. This will be the start point thing. So I think what I can do is do like two rows at a time. So I'll just do that.
Thank you.
All right, that should be all of the wool placed. I'm looking at these side wheels here, and I hate to say this, but it looks like I'm actually going to have to take them out, or at least move them. I won't take them out, like remove them forever, but I'll probably like put them over one. Like bring each of them away from the middle. Like one, because I need some space back there. I'm already going to be pushing things to make this fit as it is, so I'm gonna probably just build one on top and then take out the one behind it. All right, so luckily for a matter of something like this, it just comes down to putting the pieces exactly where they are, but just out in front. So strangely enough, kind of building over the build. Whoa, double wheel. So now that's taken care of. On to the piston placement. All right, so I think I'm starting at the back corner here. I am starting at the back corner. So that's the face of the clock. I'm in the back. And these pistons. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make a tower, and once I get to this level, four of the pistons are going to be just right in here. Just wondering. No, this isn't going to work because they're going to face upward. It's never easy. See if I can. There we go. I want to get like that on four of them. So I'll put the tower here, and this might actually help. Just being at this angle. Oh, so much easier. Oh, wait. There. So that's the first stack. Now, if I was to keep going up from this, which I am, there will be pistons on this side pointing in, and luckily there are already blocks there, except one. All right, that is one of the corners. So now we're gonna move on to that corner. If I have to clear out some of the scaffolding, that's what I'll do. But for this one, they're gonna be coming from this side, the bottom part. So let's make that happen. Yep, something like that. And go up. And we actually keep this tower. Gonna jump over. Whoa! Let's try this again. So I'm gonna go down to safety. I'm actually getting low on heart, so might want to be careful. These pistons are going to come in at this angle. And I put one too low there, didn't I? Yep. You're not pushing anything. Yes, I got it back. Coming up from here, from yeah. Actually, can't be here because that's where the pistons are gonna go. So they're gonna be pointing in from the clock face, like that. Let's see if I can get them all correct. I'm missing one. There we go. And if we carry on upwards, which we will, you can get a look at where the other ones go, which are going to be on the wheel, actually, facing in. Cool. Just one more across the face. I'm going to think ahead this time and put a block there. Now I'm going to build up in the middle because I think this is a better strategy. So these are going to come from this side. Get rid of these. Whoa, I almost went off. The next ones will be on the clock face, pointing in. Alright, and that's all the pistons. They're kind of pointing in sort of a, on the top they're going in order, sort of counterclockwise from the top, and on the bottom they're going clockwise from the top. So next part is the part that is going to be interesting. It's the redstone. I just realized how treacherous it is working out here in the middle of the rain. I think this might even be a lightning storm. I could have swore I heard lightning. Oh, there. Yep, there's lightning. I don't know. There's nothing wrong. Nothing that can really go wrong. Just being out. walking around, you know, way up in the air. Like, it's not like anything could possibly. Oh, that would be terrifying if I actually got struck. Do you mind? I'm trying to talk. Anyways, I'm building this a little wider structure around this so I can see from the outside and build better. So I'll probably put two levels, one for the upper and one for the lower. Alright, cool. This should help get around. So the first thing I'm going to do is get more reds. I'm going to jump off some items and get more other different items that I need for this. Okay. So this is roughly the amount of supplies I think I'll need. I know I need 8 repeaters, a bunch of redstone torches, and a lot of redstone. I even have a block here just in case. And some stuff to build on. So, and I'm bringing this, and some stone in case I need to make more, but I'm pretty sure this will do me right. So one of the things that these towers will need to operate is a redstone torch that's right at the bottom of each corner. And it's very specific how this works. And the tutorial that this is based off of, I'll put it in the description, aka Germinator, I think that's his name, showed how to make one of these. And what it is maybe I'll make a more official looking block just so it can't be broken as easily. It'll look something like this, and it'll be on each of the corners. And the only thing, though, is that this one's going to be very specific because if I put it there, it's going to start pushing things. So when I put it there, I don't want it to push things, so I might just take this out for now. I just have to remember that that goes there. But basically, when the torch is lit, if there's a block above it, it powers it, which powers the piston, and that's how the first piston gets pushed. And I need a way down. I think this works. Yeah! I forgot to make that a cool looking block. No! There we go. All cool looking. Alright, so if you have the mysterious floating floaty block under each corner with a torch on top of it, like those, we're going to do a little something to make it so this one doesn't, it doesn't on, there. It's turned off, which means we can put this back. And this will be a part of the trigger mechanism that drives the whole thing wild. No, it just drives the whole thing. So I'm going to put another piece that looks very similar up above all of these. It turns out that I was not done with the inside yet. But each of these pistons is going to have a block on top of it. And I'm going to have to do the same thing in the corner of that one. I'll have to go to the other side to do this. But I can show the other ones, because there's no blocks that are going to get affected. Nothing's going to turn on, theoretically. So if I put a block on top of the piston tower, and I put a torch on it, that's going to work similar to those down there, but for the next row. Because there's air above it, but when there is a piston there, it'll push it. It'll push it real good. So I'm going to do that with each of the corners, but I'm going to show the exceptional corner over there last. So if we have a torch on each corner except for this one, we've left this one blank on purpose. Here we get a better view. They're all sitting on the blocks on the corners. That's eventually going to happen here. But like I said before, there's a block up here. It's going to turn on. It's going to start pushing things. And this actually will push forever if I do that. It'll be kind of funny, but counterproductive. So the next thing I want to do is actually build the tower that comes up to this and actually starts the whole engine going. Each one of these corners is going to be a variation on the exact same thing, and they're all just wanting to get the power from this one after it's powered. That's great. Great. A plus sentence. Hooray. And the way you can do that is putting a block next to the torch and a repeater down. And each corner is going to have one of these. That's why there's 8 of them total. And they're going to have to go into some blocks. So things are going to hopefully not get too weird looking around here. But to have a sort of cleaned up version of what's going on, it's going to need to look something like this. And when I put these down, it's going to push these, which is kind of unfortunate, but I guess it will happen. Unless I counter, I not counter, what it, I'll take these out and I'm going to put this row back in. How's that sound? That's really the best way I can keep anything tragic from happening. Whoa. I think I got them all. Okay. We're good. So what's going to happen is I'm going to put this down. When this is lit, these are going to light. When this is lit, these are going to light. If I put this there, it'll grab that one. And if I put redstone on top of that block, it gets the last one. So when this tower switches on, or switches off, when it switches off, they all retract. But when it switches on, they all go out. So I'm probably going to have to figure out how those go back there. I'll probably have to rewatch this video to put them in the right spot. But for now, it's easier to take out these corners, actually. At the end, I'll show you how to put them back in order. But for now, this is what's going to happen to all of the corners. So once again, it's a block on the side of the torch. It's going to be a repeater coming out of that, so I have to get over there. That's the hardest part, just putting yourself in position to put things down. And it's going to be coming out of the block. There's no block there, so it isn't going to trigger. Gonna go into this. It's gonna have a torch on it. And there's gonna be a block on top of this. Torch coming in. And the block and the redstone on top of that. If I can just get to it. There. And since there's nothing in this corner, there's no drawback to testing if it works. So if you remove one of the torches down here, yeah, they're all pushing right now. But we gotta put it back, because the next pieces are gonna slide in, then they're gonna push, and that's how it works. That's how it works. This one's a little tricky. I will stop to say this one's kind of tricky. I have to get it into this one. So the complications arise when you have, like, I don't know, a wheel next to it or a wall. But we'll get through this, I believe. This is the one that's gonna actually mess with the face of the clock a little bit. Because in order for this to work, I have to actually take out this block. And it's gonna actually now be a part of the contraption. Funnily enough, so that comes in. Yada yada. I wonder if I can do that and get the redstone. If I could just like hit the side and it'll bounce, ricochet. Wait, I think it did. Yeah, I see the hitbox right there. Just to make sure. Yep. So if I do that... Oh, I did not know that. It helps quite a bit. Alright, we're up a level once again. And I'm going to be taking out these in the corner. It's gonna mess things up if these are in here. And I'll put them back later. So I didn't do this one yet because I was afraid it would trigger everything. But since it's not gonna anymore, I'll just go ahead and put in this like the others. So that powers the block, which means this will go this way. Into that block. Torch. Block on top of that. Torch back in. Block. Redstone on top of block. Ook. Ook do good. And I wish there was a more compact way of doing this because the parts are going to stick out. But I guess that's the challenge. Especially with this part, this is going to break through. All right, so maybe I will stick around for these. I thought I was just going to do like a no talking demonstration, but there's enough going on that's really weird that it kind of merits me explaining things. So take out part of this wheel, put the torch here. Type 6 into chat because why? Because I clicked the wrong button, that's why. Block on top of the torch. Torch on the side of that, and a block on top of that torch, and stone on top. So that isn't too, it's still kind of hidden, but you know, you can kind of see in there. There's a little redstone going on. I don't know. Maybe you want your stuff to show the working parts. I walk the line where I'm not really sure if I do or don't. So we're going to have a similar scenario here. It helps to remember it's the block that the torch is on almost always for the higher part. So this is going. Oh, I almost fell. There. Block on top of that. Torch. That. Shift click ricochet. Oh, that's so cool. That's useful. That is a useful thing. Forgot the subject of that sentence. All right, digging into this one again. This is going to go into the face of the clock, I'm guessing. So there, we'll take this out, put the torch in like that, so there's a torch powering this, a torch on that, block on top of the torch, redstone, and we're almost done. We're so close, so close. So at this point, all of the corners have their pistons powered, but there's no way to carry the signal from the lower row to the upper row. And what's going to happen is the signal is going to be, there's going to be a timing mechanism in the middle, and it's going to go up to this and start the whole machine working. But I need a way to have it jump through this and to go into this guy here. So what I'm going to do is think really hard. Alright, I think I've got it. I don't think that we need this part or this part. And I'll show why. I'm gonna get those because I want those back. Wait a minute. I want. Who cares about that? One thing's worth more than the other thing. Actually, is it? Nah, I'm not gonna think about it. Not too hard. So I'm gonna make a redstone ladder leading from this torch. So this torch is gonna go into that. And this is gonna wind its way up without hopefully doing much to anything else. Wait, there's a good way to do this. Half slabs. Oh, I don't have any. Half slabs you can run next to things and it won't power them because it won't power the half slab. I'm just going to do this really messy, really non-professionally apparently. And at least this way, I know it'll work. But this is going to wind around and up. And it's probably going to stick out the back, really disgusting. But like I said, at least it will work. And I think, yeah, if I do that, they aren't powered. So this is what the corner is. It's the exception to the rule. There's still a torch right there, but the other one's gone. And basically, when that one turns on, this one will turn on too. Okay. So that works. It goes up here. Now I have to make the bottom part work. So now it's the mechanism that's makes this whole thing happen. And it is the one from AKA Germinator's design, which is, once again, it's going to be in the description. It's a lovely, very smartly done, and very attractive video. And now that I'm thinking about it, we don't have any cobwebs. So I could actually build this thing perfectly, but not have that one part. And I don't know, maybe I can go on a last minute excursion to try to find, I think they're just in mine shafts and dungeons. That sounds like an absolute crapshoot. Like, well, whatever, we can make the pieces first. So detector rail is probably the weirdest one. Let's get some iron. A little more than that. And I'll need gold too. So actually, yeah, here's the way to make things. Oh, I just need one more. 'Cause I need 7. I guess I can make it work with 6, but whatever. I'll probably use these for other things. So there we have 12. And I believe this is how detector rail is made. Yes. Oh, 6 of them. All right. So I'm going to put this right here. And see if we can get a logical looking thing going on. I believe we can do something like this. And have the rails turn around and go up this. And let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. So be one more of these to get it to the top. And here's the top, the tippy top. Now it looks like I'll be using more cart rails than I thought, but Yeah, whatever. I'd rather have it work than have it not work. So this is basically the path for the cart to go on. I think I'm gonna make probably three level. I think I could use three, but I'm gonna go ahead with four just to give these some power. Because we need power. Powered rails need power. These have to always be on. Always. See, this one could be powered from here. All right, so I'm gonna be really weird with how I do this. I'm gonna put a block on top of this lever, and the lever will actually power that. And just so that this cart doesn't fly off the rails, literally, I'm gonna put a nice stopper here. And let's see if we can get a oh yeah. And a little break here so it only goes in one direction. So this should be the whole setup. And it's gonna have a repeater coming out of it. And when it triggers, it should be able to send a nice little pulse right up this. It'll come in and it'll trigger the entire shenaniganry. I'm not going to put that in yet just to see if it works, though. In fact, I'm gonna just see if it affects that. I'm gonna make a cart really fast. I realize that I say really fast a lot. Interesting, huh? All right, so let's see. All right, so that actually works. As of now, this would be going really fast. So fast that I don't think I would want it to actually go yet. So what I will do is put on the brakes. I love that. Start up again. That's really amusing. All right, so this is what I'm up against. Not only do I need to find a stronghold or a abandoned mine shaft, an abandoned mine shaft, but I also need to have silk touch on shears in order to get the actual cobwebs. So I think that's actually not entirely not doable, but I do need to enchant a book with silk touch. Who knows how long that'll take. And I'm thinking that maybe this exact timing device will have to wait. So I'm gonna have to have something else in the meantime that gets the job done. And what that's gonna need is I'm just gonna make a big repeater clock. I'll see what 32 repeaters gets me. That's quite a bit. Quite a few. I'm just gonna make a repeater clock. I'm not going to disassemble this because I will use this later. Once I get the resources, gonna get this going. What's interesting is I realize a repeater clock will be more accurate if I actually do want to make this thing tell a specific time. But I think there's an odd number of things going on here anyways, and I think it would just look cool moving, then have it correspond to a certain time of day. Also, if I'm sleeping, it's gonna not reset. It's just gonna keep going at whatever it is. So I think I'm okay with it just being itself. So that being said, this is what's gonna feed into it. And we're gonna have ourselves just a bunch of these. I'm gonna make sure they're all inside of the base. So I'm gonna treat it kind of like a picture frame. Actually, I need to do this. No, I don't. Nope. Nope. And maybe I'll have it go down too, because I'm starting to run out of room. It's going to go on a little adventure. Alright, so I'm not going to hook this up just yet. I'm going to break this, but I want to give this a little test run. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to give it a little pulse. Just like put it down, pick it up, just watch the pulse. So it's going around. Climbs this way faster than I can. I'm assuming it's... okay, yeah. So it's going around, it's doing its thing. So that's how often it's going to happen. Each time it passes here, the whole thing's going to shift. I'm wondering if that's still a little too often. All right, whatever amount that ends up being, that's the amount that I'll end up seeing. All right, let's try this again. Okay, that's the pulse. A little longer that time. I don't think it matters. As long as it comes through here, I'll be happy. Okay, we're good. The pulse runneth throughith the thingeth. So now, we gotta put back the thing that we took away. Sorry, we have to put away the back now. The... what? So we took some wool out of these corners. And it's time to put them back, otherwise this won't work. It'll just make a lot of noise. So as I said, I would go ahead and show you how to put those back in case you didn't remember. I put these in a safe spot so I knew I could come back to them. But those go like this, and the top row, I get into a spot where I can see it a little better. And I'll just put these here. And that should conclude, the back corner. I really want to get this going, because I've been working on this for so long. I just want to see it work. I'm growing impatient. I chose the wrong path to be impatient on, because I can't... nope. Okay, I didn't die. I just want to see it work. I don't even care if it looks ugly, I want to see it work. So I'm going to wait for it to pass through here. I think the... yeah, there it goes. Alright, so next time it goes, it'll turn on everything, if I did this right. If I didn't turn it right... then this might not be a video this week, because... oh, that'd make me sad. So, do I have a good view from somewhere? Oh, I think it went! I need a better view. I need to be watching this, and I'm stuck in the water. Alright, it's probably gone again since I've been looking around. Oops. Just need a spot. There it goes. It's going. I'm missing it because I'm facing the wrong way. I think it is actually going, though. Yeah, it's doing it. It's actually doing it. Oh, man, that's such a relief. So... the next part is to make it not look like crap, essentially. Oh, that makes me feel so happy though. Oh, there it goes. Oh, it's so great. I'm so happy. So there's actually going to be a beam going across the face at this level. And let's see if I can get over there. And placing blocks shouldn't make this not work. That's about the best I can assure. If you're worried, then place them exactly where I'm placing them. This is actually going to all go in one. Oh, look at that. There's wood there already. And let's see. I'm gonna do some work to Oh, look at that. It's upside down now. Oh, I'm happy about this. Hey guys, I'm so happy. So, what we need to do is I'm going to be kind of filling the gaps here. I believe these will be fine like that. These should be good. I'm double checking that it's not going to start powering or not powering things. But it looks like we'll be okay. Those are going to have to show. There's not much I can do about that. But now the upper half. That's one of the best sounds, like, I have no idea. I've been waiting for that sound. And I could hear it, like I've heard it already in the other in creative mode. But this is my argument for why for survival mode is sure you can make stuff. I can't put anything there because that needs to be there. You can make stuff in Minecraft creative mode. And it can be really cool stuff. Okay, it still works. But there's just something about doing it in survival. Like you have to work for every block you've had to work for every block, yes. You have to get knocked off of things. You have to almost die or die a bunch. But that just makes it that much better when you do get something built. And you're like, man, I did that. And that was not easy. So I'm gonna actually sneak a torch in here, because no one's gonna be able to see this. But I need some light. I don't want stuff spawning there. But when I look at this and I'm like, wow, I did this, and not in creative, but in survival mode, like these are the moments that I play for. Like this stuff like this. Something that a project I went into, I didn't think I could do this. I'll be honest with you guys, I was thinking like this, I don't know if I can do the tower justice. And I was thinking, well, maybe it's possible to make it work. It was such a pie in the sky, so to speak, thing. And I have so many people to thank. My mom and dad for supporting me. My other people that supported me. All right, enough blabbering. So I'm gonna make these I don't have to put all these pieces back exactly the way they were. I actually don't think they can go back exactly the way they were. So just gonna make it look as good as I can from the outside. Starting with that, I don't a actually that's the nice thing about this is you don't have to put all the pieces back. You're just making it look good from the outside. So I just realized something. This is actually going to work out extremely perfectly because this back wall is right behind this. So it's going to perfectly basically cover it like that. So you won't even see it. So there is a bit of a thing about this top part. This is actually supposed to have the steps on it next. So what I might do is I might do a little trick of the eye, make it seem like it's tapering in by, let's see, do I have some? I do. By doing this. Worst case, I could just like bring up the shell on the back and maybe that would actually look better. I'll just bring it up higher in the back. And now I can do the stairs. If I still have them, I do. So stairs are going in. And tower. Oh, that was supposed to be stairs. Let's see. Looks like all still working, so it's all still working. I think I'm at the point up here where the things I place aren't going to affect anything. All right, all I have to do now is make sure that no mobs will spawn. So I'm gonna be throwing lights around like there's no tomorrow. Right, I think I got most of the surfaces done, so I'm gonna take away the scaffolding. All this dirt. Oh, this is my favorite part, is just kind of sitting back and enjoying what you just built. 'Cause I really didn't expect, I didn't know what to expect going into this, but I kind of want to get different views on this thing. I think it turned out really good. There's a lot of stuff in there, like to pack it all in and try to make it look good at the same time. Like I still think it looks good. It does look a little bit like the Terminator, but you know, it's there are things you gotta do to make things work in this game. Let's see if I can get a back view of it. So if anything, it just probably looks like it's more like, what is going on? Having all the pieces. I can get on that hill over there. That looks like a good spot to look at it. Here's a back view. I'm actually really happy that the tower was able to cover up so much. Like, it's literally like right beneath the surface for that thing. And actually, it kind of looks cooler having the stuff on the sides because I couldn't get the side wheels to spin, but you can see the redstone actually working. And that was the cool thing about the original clock tower in Majora's Mask is that you could actually see the mechanics of it at work. So, in a way, in a strange way, I kind of held true to the design by not making it work in the same not way that. Oh, okay. So if you've been following along with me and actually building this thing, then I just have to say that you are crazy. You're just as crazy as I am. And I think you should be proud of that. And Know that if you can make this, there's a lot of things you can probably make. But anyways, I hope this was informative. I hope it was inspirational to show just what, like, that's what I want to do with this a lot, is just to show, like, there's things you can still do with Minecraft that, it is not a solved game. There's still things to be built. There's still, fortunes to be made. No, probably not. But yeah, maybe. I don't want to rule out anything, but there's still fun to be had.
I guess I've never really shown it, but I want to go ahead and do a just a quick view of this clock working and running through all of its phases. So I'm gonna get a good spot to kind of look at it from, and we can watch it. Well, we've made it all the way around. Just wanted to make sure that I actually showed that. It's only by pure coincidence that this worked to be nighttime when it started and ended. But maybe there's something I can do to it to make it so it's an exact timing thing. So maybe I'll probably make modifications to this thing as the series goes. But anyways, this has been RedMcNed, and this has been a long episode. But thanks for sticking with it, and I'll see you in the next one.